Hi, this is Steve. I'm back again. As you can see, this is the latex impression after 11 coats. As you can see, this took 14 hours to dry of taking the monkey impression. If you take a casting of latex like this on certain pieces, I suggest that once you, the latex is very damp, as you paint it, paintbrush it in there for all the features that you want, take a fan, a household fan, and put the whole mold in front of the fan, and it'll cure the latex faster. Now, as you can see, I could peel this right out. Now, here is the monkey impression itself. I suggest that sometimes if the latex still adheres to be tacky, get yourself a little bit of baby powder, just very little. Take a little bit of baby powder, put it in your hand, just like so. Take it all over the piece itself. This is still the latex casting. Will not stick together and mess up your impression. Now, very carefully, as you can see, it is conformed to my face. But now I have to trim around. I'll only take a little bit of the trimming off. Now, very carefully, on the inside here, inside where the mouth meets, you're going to cut a little hole. When this mask actually adheres to your face, that little hole you just cut on inside the monkey muzzle will actually meet flesh up with your lips. But now I'm going to put this on, I'm going to put this on the foundation of the monkey sculpture. Now I have here, which is an enamel flesh tone paint. Which is a latex enamel. This is actually going to be a foundation or a bottom foundation for when you actually add the facial makeups. This doesn't have to be the best paint job, because like I said, it's just a basic bottom outline of a foundation. doing a basic undertone foundation like this with the paints saves you a lot on the FX makeups. Now we have to let this dry down. Once this preparation has dried down, then I can start adding the facial hair, which you'll see probably more based in the next video. This is the spare wig, and I'm actually gonna cut pieces of this wig off. As you see, it's an extensive wig.